RTI channel you, the Supreme Court, and the media and public opinion, these are forcing the change now. And I see a definite change
but
in
the political parties. The political parties are scared. The political parties are scared.
They will
tell
not
you
agree.
Why.
Yes. They Arnab, they will not agree. It has to be rammed through.
If they will not agree, then let me ask you, Shazia, if you do also believe they won't agree, and if they won't agree, then what are all these political party representatives, Devesh Thakur, Satyapal Jain, and Sanjay Jha, doing on the program tonight, in your view, Shazia? Are they just pretending to agree?
Because
are they putting
the
up an act? Is that what you're saying?
The fact of the matter is, the beneficiaries of the system, they don't want to challenge this. The status quo suits them, so and they benefit from it. So this is their politics. They concentrate on vote bank politics. They pass masters in the game of winning elections. They use caste and communal lines to get votes. But when it comes to putting any kind of checks and balances on themselves, like coming under RTI, like following the Supreme Court order on debarring criminal candidates with criminal backgrounds, as well as, not allowing people with any tainted backgrounds to be there, they don't let that happen.
From Hosur, the first caller.
This is the wild allegations that Shazia is making.
From Hosur, the first caller is from Hosur.
Well, if you need any, excuse me, Shazia and me, if you need any evidence of how the Congress party is approaching transparency, you heard Mr. Rahul Gandhi today. And let me also tell you that in terms of transparency, the kind of regulations that we have bought during our 9 months
are
fairly extraordinary.
Satyapal Jain, yes, go ahead, and then the first caller. Mr. Jain.
No, he says that the best example of the transparency, the way Congress is working, is clear from the statement of Mr. Rahul Gandhi today. May I ask him, what was Rahul Gandhi doing till yesterday? Was he not aware of this amendment? What is not aware of the ordinance? Was he not in Parliament when your own government introduced a bill for that purpose? What was he doing there? Now, since you have seen the public opinion, you have seen
Mr. Jain, we have already answered this. I don't know what you have been doing all day long. We have already answered this.
The right to reject.
Calling your three ministers to explain
the right to reject.
And you yourself had been advocating
the right to reject.
It was required. It was urgent.
Keep in mind one thing.
Suddenly you take a somersault.
Yeah, I'll tell you why.
No, Rahul Gandhi is right.
The political parties,
cabinet, including Manmohan Singh, including everybody, according to Mr. Rahul Gandhi, they were doing something.
I can see the BJP is very
political parties.
I'm sorry, Arnab, for a slight divergence. Can you ask Mr. Satyapal Jain about a Babu Bhai Bogaria who is there in Mr. Narendra Modi's cabinet, although he's been convicted of corruption for 54 crores? Please ask him to answer that question before he starts his self-righteous stuff. Relax. I asked you a question. Give me an answer.
Who has been accused in the Colgate scam? Will you reply to that?
The impact of this is so extreme, and I think it's slightly patronizing to say one thing that this is a good idea. It's not just a good idea. I say this with absolute conviction that just as the people of India were absolutely 100% sure that they will not allow the so-called fake political consensus on the ordinance, push this ordinance to allow criminals in politics too, I can say with absolute conviction that the people of India will not allow this opportunity to reject candidates who are communal, corrupt, casteist, hypocritical, nepotistic, to allow to be elected. Our first caller from Hosur is Mr. Sivaswamy, I think. Mr. Sivaswamy, good evening. This is Arnab here.
Good evening, sir. Mr. Arnab.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yesterday I was waiting for the Maruf Raja, what I wanted to say. Maruf has said regarding the Pakistan talk. Today I want to ask only one question to all the politicians. Are they the masters of the people of India, or we are the masters for them? Please ask them to explain it. If they are the slaves for us, they have to abide by the law of Supreme Court which has passed. That's all. Thank you very much.
Sivaswamy, don't. Thank you very much. I'll get another caller come in. Let's take a second caller. Hear the voices tonight. People tonight are reclaiming their right to have a stake in the way this government is run. Mohandas Pai, are you in? Just before I go to our next caller, are you in any doubt today that what Rahul Gandhi has done there today is because he is aware that public opinion is against the ordinance? Similarly, public opinion is for the right to reject.
I'll see how strange it is, Arnab, that Rahul Gandhi listened to public opinion rather late in the day and made the statement and overruled the cabinet of the government of India.
That's
the whole cabinet has become a bunch of you know, people who have no power. Their decision of the cabinet has been overruled by one single individual who is a member of parliament, but who listened to the people of this country.
Well, I hope the government.
The lines, what this means.
I hope the government also listens to the people of this country when Manmohan Singh meets Nawaz Sharif tomorrow, and Manmohan Singh realizes there the way the people of this country are angry there about his puppy juppies and candy floss diplomacy, yes, which he may be attempting to do once again with Nawaz Sharif. Our next caller this evening is Pawan, and Pawan is calling in from Pune. Yes, go ahead. And I'm getting a lot of messages. We'll take a few more callers. Pawan. Good evening, Pawan.
Yeah, hey, Arnab. I'm glad to hear from you. And really, I love your show a lot. You really take the spirit of people, really. And you're doing a good job, really. Thanks a lot. Yeah, I'm actually also glad to see people like Shahzad Ilmi, who is there currently, because now with this Aam Aadmi Party, a new front has opened for progressive politics to come in. So I think that's pretty good, too. But my point of view is, firstly and foremostly, people will lose faith in the system when they have a right to reject, where our representatives and who we want to elect, and we see that they are tainted or something like that, and then we just put right to reject. So to me, the only thing that's a fail in the system, democratic system that we have out here, that's the first thing. And the second thing is that will it not give a paradigm shift where think tanks within the political parties will start thinking about whom do they feel within their constituencies?
And given that it's a good point you make there, Pawan, you make two points out there. I'd like to one of those who's supporting this, Ms. CSR Subramaniam raised his hand out there. What the point being made by our caller is, will it result in too much cynicism? Will people, instead of looking for the good points among those who are out there, will they only exercise the choice as more an act of defiance? What do you think? No,
Arnab. I think the thrust of the point was that if we have the right to reject, shouldn't you have the right to write in a new name, which is available in the US and elsewhere? I think this is the first step today. We are now going slowly to move to write in, right to recall, referendum. All of these are going to come in course of time. We'll also have the system. If the total number of rejections equal the highest number, then the whole countermanded. It won't be for all these are going to come in course of time. Don't be in a hurry. We have now started the game.
That's a good point. I think
baby steps.
Ramit from New Delhi is our next caller. Ramit, good evening.
Good evening, Arnab. I just don't want to talk about BJP or Congress.
Yes.
I'm just talking about Aam Aadmi Party, which asked for holistic about their own ideas. I want to know that the worst form of non-adherence to Lokpal has been done in Gujarat. I hope Sajjad Imli agrees to that. Now, why has not our friend Kejriwal, who is my college mate, has not gone to Gujarat? Is he scared of getting check encounter? Or our friend, our great man who did all this honoration in Delhi, Hazare, not gone to Ahmedabad? Is he afraid of Nathuram Godse syndrome?
Well, I think you're slightly straying there, but I'll let Shazia take that. I'll take one more call. You're slightly straying there. Romit, that's a good point you make. It's fairly provocative, but it's slightly straying away from the subject, though it got a few laughs there from both the Congress and the BJP, interestingly. Yes, Shazia.
Nevertheless.
No, it's a reality.
There are countless discussions and instances in the public domain where we've talked about Gujarat, Lokayog, and how it's a big travesty. And I tell people who came out for Lokpal and who support BJP to look at Gujarat Lokayog, which is really a betrayal of whoever believed in the idea of an ombudsman. So that's that. Not just Arvind Kejriwal, but Anna Hazare has spoken eloquently a number of times So maybe our good friend is not aware of the fact, but you can actually, I can send him details of that.
You know,
here when we're talking about right.
No, Arnab yes, Romit is right. Arnab Romit is right. The Aam Aadmi Party has soft pedaled Narendra Modi. Everybody knows it.
Only because
everybody knows the Aam Aadmi Party has been a team B of the BJP. And they have been self-righteous, they have been sanctimonious. They have tried to ignore Narendra Modi's corruption.
We are not discussing Gujarat tonight, gentlemen.
They have
not permitted the.
But let me tell you, but Romit is right. As Shazia Elmi cannot afford to take a self-righteous stance
but
here.
That's, it's not the
they
point
have
here.
Played very
the
convenient politics.
Right
the world knows
reject.
That.
No, we are not
anyway,
discussing.
I'm just putting the facts.
Gentlemen, can I be Sanjay once say we are not discussing.
But Romit is right.
With respect. We are not discussing Gujarat tonight. I know we discuss Gujarat very often. What I'm actually seriously discussing is, I was looking at some statistics, Mr. Devesh Thakur, and I found that in Rajasthan and Delhi, two states which are going to the elections, the margin of victory in 30-40% of the constituencies was 500, 1000, 1500, 2000. And I wonder here today, Mr. Devesh Thakur, if this, the impact of this right to reject could be that those groups of people, including the fence sitters, could just say right to reject, which actually makes things fairly complicated for the two political parties. When the margins are narrow, even 100, 200 people moving this way or that in a MLA constituency can make a difference. It can make a huge difference.
Yes, it can, certainly, Anup. That's what I said. I told you we welcome this as an idea. I would really like to see how this can be put into practice. And as you said, it's really going to make a difference, no doubt about it.
Last,
what would be the eventual outcome remains to be seen. That's all what I'm saying.
Absolute. But you know,
we would prefer compulsory voting made more practically possible. Voting is made more practically possible. I would like to consider that as an option as well.
Well, last caller from Nagpur, and it's Sanjay. It's not Sanjay Jha. It's Sanjay calling in from Nagpur. Yes, Sanjay.
Yeah, Arnab, this is Sanjay from Nagpur. I am a diehard fan of Times Now, and I really enjoy the program and I'm a regular watcher. First of all, I would like to thank Annaji, because of whom this particular right to reject has come, I feel, because the amount of people that had participated is a result of that.
That's right.
I thank Anna for that. Secondly, I think the way Rahul barged in the press conference, I think he had the information before Times Now that the right to reject is already there. That's why he has come. And
I think it happened before. No, I must say, the right to reject from Supreme Court came at about 11:30. To be fair, Rahul Gandhi's press conference was closer to 2 o'clock. Yeah.
Yeah, I think both practiced the right of reject immediately after this result was done. And as a voter, I am very, very happy that this kind of a decision has been made. And I am very sure that political parties will have sleepless nights now.
Well, I think Satyapal Jain and Sanjay Jha and Devesh Thakur need to get together. And it would be wonderful, it would be heartwarming, I'd say, for all political parties to come together to give this chance to people. You know, Satyapal Jain, voters are mature. They can decide. Yeah. They won't just say right to reject for the sake of it. Will they, Mohandas Pai?
They want a choice.
They want a choice.
They want a choice, Arnab. They want a choice. It is democracy at work.
They want to make the choices.
And in case they're very angry, they'll make their voice felt.
And we should welcome it, right? We should all welcome it if they want
absolutely.
That
choice. Absolutely.
And if you look at Tamil Nadu or Himachal Pradesh or Uttarakhand, it's two parties. Basically, the two parties in the... So now people will be forced, they will be putting pressure on the political parties to field better candidates.
Okay.
Because it's one or the other and there's no real choice.
Okay.
And the selection process is so opaque.
1 minute, please. I've got some breaking news coming in, which will be interesting here right now. To all up. Before I wrap, I'm going to wrap this part of the panel up, but I'd like some of our political panelists just stay on. They may find it interesting, the news that we are getting here. Rob Rashtrapati.